Hello everyone, you're welcome once again to Frankly Speaking with Glory Elijah. Yes, how have you guys been? Good, I know. Okay guys, so if you are new to this channel, please do not forget to subscribe and turn on your post notifications so that you can be notified when I put up a new video. And if you already belong to the family, hey, hi, I hail to you guys. All right guys, for today's episode, I have a very important topic to talk about, and this one especially for mothers, daughters, anybody that is female out there. All right, now the topic is mothers and daughters. All right, I am a daughter, I am not yet a mother, but I have a mother and I have sisters who are mothers. I believe that you too, you could be a mother or you have sisters who are mothers. All right, now what I want to talk about specifically guys is protection for the female, for the girl child especially. This topic was prompted by an event that occurred to someone very close to me, and it caused me to think about what I could possibly do to remedy such situation and to stop such things from happening frequently around me. This is what happened. A lady, all right, that has three daughters. She doesn't have money, she's not empowered, she doesn't really have anything that she's doing to bring in income to her family. Her husband is also jobless. All right, now one of the daughters goes out to a neighbor's house to ask for food or money to get food, and what happened is this neighbor turns out to be a young guy, and what did the guy do? The guy raped this young girl. This girl is not more than 5 years old. Yeah, this girl is just 5 years old, and this guy raped this girl. Now, on getting home to the mother checks out and like, what happened? Look at the way you're working and look at the way you're also walking, you know. So what happens is the mother beats this girl up, beat her up, and then pounded pepper and put the pepper in her private parts. That was what happened. Nobody even looked out for the person that raped this child. Nobody brought this person to justice. When I heard of this story, I was very upset. Now I asked so many questions that nobody could answer. Where was the mother when this child left the house? Where were the other neighbors when this child walked into this particular person's house? And mind you, this person already has a reputation for sleeping with people around and also, you know, defiling young girls. Now that was how this young child was defiled, without anything being done to that person that carried out this very insidious act. Now what I have to say is this: the moral of the story is, mothers, please, if you have two eyes, put 20 eyes on your daughters. Parents generally, but mothers, this duty falls upon you. You should always ensure that the safety of your child, of your daughter, is paramount. Yes, I know that things are hard. Everybody is hustling. Everybody is looking for how to put food on the table. Everybody is looking for how to look good. Everybody is looking out for how to meet up to societal expectations. But also remember, the well-being, the welfare, the image, the future of your child, your daughter especially, matters. Now, if you are inside your house, please ensure that your daughter is inside your house. If you are supposed to be at work and your daughter is supposed to be at school, please ensure to always call in on the school to check up on your child. If your child returns from school with a bruise or with a mark or maybe an unusual countenance, dig deep into the matter. Ask your child questions. Talk to your child. I grew up in a time, let me not say I grew up in a time because I am still growing up, all right? But I grew up in a time where I would be scared to talk to my parents. I'd be scared to talk to my mother. And so many things happened, not defilement per se, but then so many things happened that I wish that I could have talked to my mom about it, especially my dad, my mom, you know? So mothers especially, please ensure to always have conversations with your daughters. Maybe not conversations that will make them talk about rape or anything, because nobody prays for such to happen, but always make sure that you talk to your child right from when they are still babies. Talk to them, make sure that they're able to open up to you, and always put, as I said, 20 eyes on them. 20 eyes is not too much. I know that God is the one that protects everybody, but also you can also play your own part in protecting your daughters. All right guys, all right, so as I said earlier, If you have not subscribed to this channel, please do well to click on the subscribe button and become a part of the family. And if you have your own opinion about this topic, or if you have an experience to share, please do well to put that in the comment box below. And that's a wrap for this episode of Frankly Speaking with Glory. Thanks for watching.